Hey guys, it's Jeff Lafferty, and episode number 80, man, is it 86? I think it's 86 already, of the ArtCast. How's everybody going? I wanted to mention, like, right in the beginning of this video, because I usually wait and kind of bring up people later, you know, their links and stuff, and I think sometimes, you know, people don't watch that long, so they kind of miss it. But I noticed Jonathan Myers, he does really cool videos. I wanted to, like, promote him. I'll put a link in this video to his show. And I really liked his last one. He's kind of talking about, well, a lot of different things. It's hard to, like, sum these up because people kind of birdwalk around to different topics. But it was a really good show. And he does them pretty often, which is really nice. It's nice to find somebody who's, like, consistent, you know. I notice now, like, what's kind of happening is people jump on the bandwagon or whatever of doing these videos, and then they kind of drop off, you know. And that's cool. At least you get some, but it's kind of nice to see somebody like you, you know. You can kind of count on them. You sit down and start drawing, you kind of, like, go through my email, and then, like, oh, there's his, so that's really nice. And then I noticed Marshall Couture is doing his 100 Days of Comics again. He kind of fell off a little bit, now he's back on, and that's just cool. I don't know why I, like, listen to his show, but I do. So, and his last one was kind of talking about, I mean, he talks a lot about making money and, you know, the ideas of making money, and, I mean, not that it's a money show, but it's just, you know, it's his sort of thinking out loud about, you know, what works and what doesn't for him, and just the struggles of, maybe I'm summing it up too much for the guy, but of what he's doing, which I agree, it's a tough thing to make, especially comics work. I was in the ArtCasters chat over the weekend. Let's see, who all was in there? This guy Jay Ferguson, who, actually I should have mentioned him too, he's doing videos now. He just did his first one. I hope he keeps going with it, because I found it really interesting. And watching him airbrush, I've never really paid much attention on, like, to how to airbrush, like, really good airbrushing, you know. I was kind of just, you know, I just used my airbrush for what I use it for, and then I didn't really ever kind of study technique with it or anything. And he does, like, all airbrush, you know, paintings and, like, on motorcycles and stuff, and it's really interesting to see, like, how he does it, you know. So I hope he does more videos. But anyway, yeah, he was in there. And his website's, like, airheadcustom.com, I think. But since he's a YouTube guy, I'll just link it. Because I can put YouTube links, you know, in my videos, so. Let's see, who else was in the Hangout? Peter Palmiotti was obviously in there. John Grisecki, he's, does a webcomic. And I'm gonna put all the links in the show notes too, so you guys can find them. Who else was in there? Man, now I'm, like, drawing a blank. Andrew Jones. He does lots of different stuff, really, movie art and stuff. And other stuff. Brandon Kinney, who's, like, awesome. I was, like, so happy to see him come. He's, like, a sketch card artist, but way more than just that, though. Just fucking damn good artist, you know? And, let's see, who else was in there? Let me check. I Okay, I'm back. Actually, I hope that I didn't slow my camera down. But actually, Kevin Cross, which I'm like, how the heck did I forget him? But yeah, he was the other one. And he had some good stuff, too. But why I kind of brought that up was a lot of guys were talking about different ways of, like, you know, making money, promoting, all that kind of stuff. You know, for everything from working for sketch card companies to just a lot of different things. And I'm not going to go into it. If you want to listen to it, though, it's definitely worth listening to, I think. But, like, you know, just talking about, like, the comic side of it, it's, like, it's so tough, you know? And it's really, like, you know, it's more in your face in that situation than, like, when you're talking about it in comparison to, like, sketch cards and stuff. Because, like, all of those things are a product that you can sell, you know? And sketch cards, prints, original art, all that kind of stuff is, like, something you can sell. And you can sell comics, too, but it's like you've got to put together, you know. I mean, you know, nobody even seems to sell, you know, single issues anymore. So the whole 24-page thing seems to be going out the window. And now everybody's, you know, selling graphic novels. So you got, like, a graphic novel that's, like, 80 pages long or something. I think that's even kind of a small one. And how many pictures is that, you know? It's probably like 400 pictures or something, you know? It's just like, it's a crazy amount of work to get to a payday, I guess. So then, like, that whole option kind of just goes out the window. In my mind, you know? It's an option because if, like, you're really doing comics, you're really actually producing pages, and that's going to come. And then you got something to sell at cons or whatever, or on your site. But that, to me, like, that, I mean, I don't have the answer to all that, but that's probably, you know, it's just, it seems like if you really were only, like, you know, kind of come up with any kind of business model for comics, it almost seems like it's got to be this whole, like, either the Kickstarter thing, which ain't easy, or it's or something like Patreon or something, which I, once again, you know, that's not easy either. I find Patreon really tough, and I mean, I appreciate everybody that's on there, but it's just tough to grow it, I think, you know. So it's like if you're doing a webcomic or something and you want Patreon to be all your money, then that's hard, you know. The Kickstarter thing kind of is bringing up something I've been thinking about, which is a book, because just on, you know, like, I counted up how many drawings I did, you know, just since I've left my job and stuff and started these art casts, and I mean, it was like over 60, you know, pieces, which is like plenty for an art book, not including like all the other stuff I already had on my site. And I think like an art book just has got to happen at some point, you know. And I guess I'm just wondering, like, if a Kickstarter is, should I do it in a way, you know? Should I make such a huge production out of doing a book? I don't know. I mean, on the one hand, I think it would be good, you know, and it might give me a big chunk of money, but also I just think, I don't know. I didn't really want to talk about that in this show. But I do like Marshall's show. I mean, now I guess I brought it up, I gotta like talk about it. But I mean, I've talked about it in some other live shows and stuff, which is just, you know, I don't want to hurt my sales at the moment by running a Kickstarter. And that might seem kind of like really, like I think what I said that in a different show, it was kind of like, you know, I don't know. It almost seemed kind of like, well, that's a great problem to have or something like that because I'm selling and stuff. But I don't know. It's just the reality of my situation, you know. Oh, you know what? I should actually finish talking about this though, because I don't want people to get the wrong idea. But I mean, by that I worry that like if I started a Kickstarter, people would, you know, go there and pledge rather than do whatever they were going to do that month. And if those are like the guys who are like, you know, because I get a lot of repeat sales. I have people who are like, you know, definitely buy art all the time and buy art monthly and stuff. And, you know, I don't want a chance like, you know, those people going to Kickstarter and giving me money there. And then all of a sudden I'm broke, you know, for that month. And at this point, you know, being broke for a month would just end me, you know. And then there wouldn't, you know, it wouldn't matter if the Kickstarter funded or not. I couldn't get to the end of it. And I wouldn't be able to get to, like, you know, the month after Kickstarter to get that money anyway. So I don't know. Hopefully that didn't sound all super cocky and stuff. But I guess, like, you know, like when I started this video, I was kind of thinking a lot about Marshall's video because he was kind of talking about that, like wanting to make a living at it and things like that. And that's kind of more what I was thinking about, was just, you know, the fact that comics is so many drawings to get to a payday. And then I think too, it's like, I mean, it's more, I think, about like the fan base you can build up with comics, you know, which has got to be tough, you know. That's why I almost think like a thing like Kickstarter is almost like, in a way, like the only kind of answer, because it's like, I don't know, there's a lot of examples where you see it work. Like the Bean, is his name Travis Hansen? Is one of them. You know, he runs several Kickstarters, or he has run several Kickstarters, and it's worked for him. And they're not all massive funders, but it seems to be like every time he gets to the, like the book point or something, you know, he runs one and gets funded for whatever, and then makes the book, and that's like his sales. I mean, he's almost like doing that as just like, I don't know, what do I say? It's almost like a, well, like a giant pre-order for his books, and that's what works for him, which is really cool. Of course, there's like Jason Brubaker, who's pretty famous for making that model work for him too. And then Daniel Lesquet, I think his name is Lesquet, Wormworld Saga guy, making that work. Now I'm just sitting here thinking, like, all those guys, you know, if you look at their like I said, business model, it's almost kind of like predicated on doing a book, and maybe I should really start thinking about getting a book out and do a Kickstarter or something. But And you know, the thing about Patreon, I mean, I guess I'll just go into this here too, because I mean, Patreon, I've been having a trouble with Patreon because of the print. You know, I sell prints, or I, you know, give away prints as a pledge on there. And what I've been thinking about doing is stopping Patreon, just like, don't take any payments. I mean, this month's over. It's like, it's what's going to happen is what's going to happen. But like, for the next month, is just stop taking payments, and just stop the whole Patreon thing for a month until I can get caught up and send out all the prints that I owe, because I owe a few people prints. And then I was thinking, like, come back. Not even next month, or just whenever I can get this done. You know, because I mean, it's just like, you know, I think if you go back a month here, you know, I would be complaining about the same thing, which is like, you know, getting everybody their Patreon prints. And I think in some ways I kind of have set up a little bit of a flawed system. Because I can't afford to send anything for free. And it's not that it's free. You know, I owe people prints that have, you know, pledged money, but it's also, I'm in this really screwed up situation of where, like, every month I'm right down to the wire on my money, and I'm just scrambling like hell, you know, to make the, you know, the mortgage every month. And that's just like, once again, you know, that's what's happening. And so, like, everything, you know, all of the money and stuff gets sucked into that. And then, like, you know, the next month I start to, you know, like, once I get it paid, I start to build it back up. And there's, like, expenses that just sort of, like, have to happen. And one of the big ones is shipping. So that takes a chunk, and then another one is just honestly just buying art supplies, you know, and stuff like that. I mean, as you can see, like, this pencil, it's just funny. It's like, I you know, like, I don't know. I just haven't had, you know, money to order pencils, so, you know, I'm just like scrapping together all my freaking pencils, trying to, you know, keep going with what I got. And it's just, you know, and that's not at all like any of the fault of like anybody on Patreon. It's like my fault more because of kind of like, I think just the system I set up there. Because, you know, it just, I didn't charge shipping for prints that go overseas and stuff. And that was an expense. And you know, like, the other thing is, like, you know, I'll admit it, like, when I have, like, eBay sales, I send my eBay prints first because I'm worried that they're going to give me bad feedback and stuff on there and screw up my eBay thing, you know. And it's just, like, it's just, all of that is just adding to, you know, and then, of course, you know, you get behind on your prints, and then, you know, the next month rolls around, and you're like, oh, I can't remember what they wanted. And then there's other things, you know, like prints, you know, people, you know, they ask for prints that aren't prints, and you're like, oh, I gotta set up a print file for that one and everything, and it would seem easy, but, you know, you also have to, like, paint a picture today and all that good stuff, so, it's, you know, it's just a lot, I've let it get behind. I'm not sort of trying to shirk any of that. But it's just, you know, I don't know. You know, I got to figure out some kind of solution. And then on top of all that kind of stuff, you know, my own screw up, there's just a flaw in the Patreon system that I see. And I think it's, you know, and this can be for anybody out there that's doing one. I don't know if you can learn from this or what, or if you're going to set one up. But I set mine up to, you know, as you get paid per content. And then, like, I was always planning on doing, like, a piece every week and a video every week. And that kind of worked, you know. When I first set this thing up, it was, that's how it was. It was like I was working a job. I didn't have more time. I didn't have enough time to do more than one piece anyway each week. And I also, I didn't have enough time to do more than one piece a week anyway, and plus, like, a, you know, plus a video, that's like a full week's work if you're, you know, if you got, you know, if 8+ hours a day is dedicated to a job. Now I don't have a job, all of a sudden I cranked my, and I didn't expect to do this, but I cranked my output up to a video every day, and all that good stuff, and a ton of art. And it, that's like awesome, but it's like it didn't really fit the model I had on Patreon anymore. Because all of a sudden, you know, it's like I can't charge people every day when they were expecting me to be charged like every week for one piece of content. So I kind of made a deal with everybody on there that I would only just charge once a week for like on Mondays, basically. So like I only charge like, you know, on Mondays like 4 times a month. So like this Monday was free anyway. But the thing about that that is kind of screwed up is, you know, everybody can set a cap on there for like what they pay. And I've had at different times people come in and they set their cap at their pledge level kind of thing, which means like if they pledge $3 per content, which is basically $3 a week. Basically the way it's supposed to work is they pay it 4 times a week, and then that ends up being $12, and then I send them a print for $12 basically at the end of the month. But when people can go in there and they can set that pledge level at whatever they want, so some people will go in and they'll pledge, you know, $3, and they'll set their cap at $3, so for a whole month they'll only pledge $3, and then, you know, they'll expect me to send them a print, and it's like, that's just, you know, the, I'm not saying, you know, it could be confusion, I don't know exactly, you know, it's a confusing system, and, if I can catch that, that's fine, but if I don't catch that, then that screws up the whole thing, you know. Because, I mean, it's supposed to, like, you know, be something that makes money, not loses money. And then the other part that's awesome is, like, Patreon only pledges at the end of the month. Or they only... They collect everybody's money at the end of the month. So people can pledge, you know, during the month, and they can be on there doing their thing, and then they can just sort of like step out of there, or they can, like, you know, let their credit card expire or something before Patreon will charge it. And then, you know, once again, if I'm not watching, I'm not on that and like checking like what every single person pays and stuff like that, then once again I can like send people prints and not get paid for it, and lose money, you know, and lose shipping money and all that kind of stuff. And I'm not making a ton on there anyway. So that, like I just said, it's that whole thing is, you know, it's more my fault because of the way I set it up, but I set it up in a, you know, under different circumstances, like, you know, a few months ago when everything was completely different in my life. And I'm not complaining. I guess I'm just trying to, like, kind of come to, like, a solution. And that's why I was thinking, like, if I just stop it for a bit. And I don't want to do that because I don't want to lose the people I have on there. And I think that's probably what will happen is, like, once people... sort of have the opportunity to step off, they're just going to take it and go. And I don't blame them. Who wants to have your, you know, credit card charged every month and things like that? And that's just reality. I'm not being down on it or anything. I'm just saying, like, hey, you know, this is like what Patreon's like. I think it works great if you're one of these guys, and that's like the majority of Patreon, where they don't give anything but just some kind of like content thing. And I've thought about that, switching it over to that kind of thing. But anyway, like what I was thinking is, like, if I stopped it for a month, I could like basically switch it to a monthly charge, and switch all my donations to be like, you know, the equivalent of a month, just a monthly charge. And I think that honestly that would be better, because then I wouldn't have people that kind of come in and you know what I mean, and do that cap thing and sort of get a print for nothing, you know what I mean. I don't know, I just feel like every time I think I start talking about Patreon, I feel like I'm bitching, and then I feel also like people are giving me money on there, so I have no right to bitch and all that kind of stuff. But I don't know if that's true, though. I mean, I give away prints on there. So, I mean, I looked at it like print sales, as long as, you know, we're just talking here. I mean, that's the way I set it up, was like, okay, I sell prints anyway, so I'm just going to sell these people prints. And then, you know, the whole thing just got out of hand because, you know, I'm broke and stuff. But, anyway. I don't know. I don't want to complain, but I do need to do something about Patreon. So I think at the very least, I'm just not going to charge this month until I can get the prints out to the current people that I owe prints to, you know. And I'm so fucking awesome at shipping. That's like the thing that just drives me crazy. Is I'm like, I'm such a good, like, guy about shipping. I've, like, had, you know, years of this kind of stuff. And, you know, it's like when people buy off of me anywhere on eBay or whatever, it's like I deliver quickly and, you know, do good service and all that kind of stuff. And, like, you know, on this stupid Patreon thing, I have, like, so, like, drop the ball just because of, like, just the weird nature of it, you know what I mean? It's so much different than, I don't know, just print sales, because, I don't know, with print sales, you know, it's like you're selling a print, so you're ready, you got the file ready, you're ready to go. But with Patreon, it's just, like, inevitably, like, I'll get these ones that are like, can you give me a print of, like, you know, XYZ piece from, you know, 5 years ago, and I'll be like, yeah, all right, you know, and then I'll go and I'll find that piece, and I'm like, you know, it's like, it's such a pain in the neck, because then you have to do all this work to just set up this one print that somebody wants that's like not for sale, and then it's like, if it's a weird size, you're like, well, what do I stick it on, like, you know, I don't know. I'm sure everybody could go like, oh, you know, that's like, you know, that's, why is that such a big pain in the ass and everything? That should just be easier, just printing out something. And I guess that's true too. Well, actually, it's not. That's not true. Because it's a pain to print stuff up, you know. And it's a super big pain if you're like, you know, having the troubles like I have now, which is like, I sell a lot of prints. I you know, I run out of paper. I run out of ink, you know, on a routine basis. And I struggle like hell to sell something so I can go to, you know, copy shop and, or not the copy shop, but, you know, so I can go to wherever and get my paper and buy my ink off eBay and stuff like that. And, I don't know. Now I'm just complaining. But it's tough. There's a guy, he commented on my thing, one of my videos, and he said that he respects my work ethic, and I really appreciate that. And that was something I was going to say with as far as Marshall goes and stuff, when he was talking about making money and all that kind of stuff. And I appreciate Marshall's work ethic, because he did a comic, you know what I mean, in this 100 Days of Comics thing that everybody's doing, man. It's like, that guy got a comic done. And that is super cool. And that's what's going to make it work for you, dude. you know? And that's, like, when the guy said that about my work, that's the only thing that I can control right now. Is just how much stuff I can paint. How many hours I can put in painting. And that's, like, it. You know, I can try to be as smart as I can about what I pick, and, you know, but it's still a crapshoot. And you still make a mistake every now and then, and something doesn't sell, and that's, you know... But then even that doesn't hurt you that bad. I mean, it's you know, when stuff doesn't sell, it's like, it'll sell eventually, you know. You just put it back up, and you just go on to the next thing, you know. And eventually a buyer that's going to be in love with that piece is going to come along, but... You know, I don't know. It's like, you know, just like all the troubles I'm talking about. That's the only thing you can do. You know, you can, like, freaking, you know, freak out and, I don't know, have all sorts of, you know, issues and all that kind of stuff. But when it really gets down to it, the only thing that's going to help you is another piece selling off of somewhere. And that's just, like, the way I look at it, you know. That's why, like, when the whole freaking avalanche is coming down on my head, I'm making a video and I'm like drawing a piece, and the thing's going on eBay tomorrow, because that's the way I deal with it, and that's, like, the only thing you can do, you know, is just do that. It's because it's, like, your only chance. I don't know. That's what kind of cracks me up, because, you know, I complain about the trolls and all that kind of stuff, and the trolls are never about that, you know. They're always about, like, they always have all sorts of issues about other stuff, you know, but they never sort of think about that aspect of it, you know. I kind of was, like, cryptic there, but, you know, it's like they just, I don't know, they have a problem with, like, what you're drawing, or... or just, I don't know what you're saying or something, and, you know, they never sort of, I don't know, just that whole thing of, like, you know, just putting meat on the table every night just escapes them. And that's why I think a lot of them are just sort of, kind of failed artists in a way, or, like, they wanted to be something, or they've tried something and it doesn't work for them, so then they really, you know, have a real axe to grind when you're trying something, you know. I had a couple friends like that a long time ago that just, you know, nothing worked, or at least they didn't think it worked, so when you had an idea, they just really went out of their way to sort of tell you that that's not the way to do it. And, like, now I look back on that, and, man, it's like, you know, if I'd have had the brain I have now, like, back then, I really would never have been friends with them, not because I don't like them, but just because of that. Because they just spent their time sort of, figuring out why they can't do it, and figuring out, you know, all that good stuff. If I had had it to do over again, I think I wouldn't have, I think that's, like, the thing I'm always coming back to, is I wouldn't have quit. I wouldn't have sort of, like, ever looked at the easy way and said, like, I'm going to take that route. I think if there's, like, a consistent thing in my past. Oh, there's a siren. That I come back to is, it's like that easy route, or that, you know, and by that I mean, like, just taking the quick job. Not art job, I'm talking about just normal job to pay the bills. I mean, there's times when I had to do that, and there's, like, you know, there was, like when I started painting houses, that was a time when there was no more screwing around, and I had to, like, figure out something. And that's what I did. So like that is not to me like the easy way out. But there was times like just when I was doing comics, I just wish I would have been like, you know, a lot more like I wish I, you know, like back in the day, I wish I would have went to San Diego every year and got a table there, and not, because I could have done that pretty easily with the money I had and stuff. And I don't know. And I didn't do that, you know, and it cost me. I don't know, there's so many times when I just kind of like took a job because I was like, I'm just going to take this job and, you know, do my comic on the side or work on this on the side. And, you know, just that whole thing, just it never panned out because, you know, once you do that, which I'm sure I'm not telling anybody anything they don't know, it just, that job just takes up all your time and it kills your career, basically. And there was just times when I did that because I felt like, okay, I need to, like, be responsible. But, I mean, for Christ's sake, I was, like, young. I didn't have, like, responsibilities at all, really, just to feed myself, you know. It's like, when you're, like, 18, or not 18, but, you know, up to about 30, unless you have kids and a wife and stuff, it's like, who gives a shit if you get kicked out of your house, you know what I mean? I mean, it's just like, it sounds like harsh, but it's like, in my case, I mean, fuck, I could have just gotten my truck and drew in there, for Christ's sake, you know? I mean, it wouldn't have been the end of the world, you know? I could have camped out for a week until I found a different place, you know? It's just like, I wish I'd have took the chances that I should have took back then and not sort of taken the easy route. But then also, you know, that the thing about that is like, you don't get this wisdom, like, back then. You know, you don't see that when it's happening. You see that when you're older, you know, and you have even more sort of, you know, when the time goes by, because you don't realize like how, you know, you really are under the gun to make it work when you're younger, and it just gets harder as you get older. So I don't know. I don't know where I'm going with all that. I should probably wrap this video up. It's probably getting pretty long. And hopefully everybody got some value of that and all that kind of stuff. And I really appreciate the comments from everybody. And I appreciate the shares. That's super cool. And everybody that buys my stuff off of eBay and commissions me. And I'm going to... This will, of course, be up on eBay probably when this video goes up. But then also I'm going to auction a couple commissions on there. Which are like a black and white one and then probably a color one. And so if you're interested in getting me to draw, you know, your favorite movie character or something, you can bid on that. Other than that, I appreciate it, guys. I'll talk to you Wednesday. See ya.